recession on the horizon. Atlanta Business Chronicle finance reporter Phil Hudson talks about it all with SunTrust Advisory Services chief market strategist Keith Lerner in this edition of the Tea Leaves.
So Keith, the tax bill has been dominating headlines recently. I wanted to get your take on the bill and if you think it's going to pass.
Yeah, well, we just had the House pass the bill this week, and soon it's going to go over to the Senate. It will be a little bit more challenging, but ultimately, we think the bill does pass. And the number one reason why we think the bill passes is there's a high motivation for Republicans to get the bill passed ahead of the midterm elections. They don't want to go into the midterms without showing something done.
So what kind of economic impact do you think that's going to have?
You know, broadly, we think it's pro-growth. Of course, there's going to be winners and losers. But from more of a corporate side, if you bring down the corporate tax rate, if you can bring some cash from overseas and you incentivize companies to invest, that's good. And you know, if we look back at 2003, the last time we had some tax cuts, what we saw is a short-term jolt to the economy. So we went from about a 2% economy to about a 4% economy. And I think similarly, we'll see a jolt this time. Now, longer term, I think the U.S. economy is still likely to be growing in a 2.25 type of move. But short term, I certainly expect some type of upside to that.
So what if the bill doesn't pass? What kind of impact do you think that will have?
Well, more from a market perspective, I think we'll have a hiccup. I mean, I think from a stock market perspective, we could see something in the range of a 5 to 10% pullback. Because, you know, first of all, we've gone a long time without any type of pullback, and we're somewhat vulnerable if this doesn't go through. But that said, when you look at different baskets of stocks, whether that's high-priced stocks or high tax rate stocks or small-cap stocks, the type of companies that would benefit from tax relief, they actually have been underperforming. So the market is not totally baking this in. So I think it would be a short-term reaction, a negative reaction. But ultimately, we've had markets going higher without tax reform for 8 or 9 years. As long as the global economy can continue to move forward, I think stocks will be okay. It may just limit the upside.
Yeah, I think 83% of the companies you track were profitable last quarter. What do you attribute that to, and what sectors are you seeing as kind of the highest performing?
It's not just earnings. The bottom line, we're seeing revenue beat. So, you know, companies actually are benefiting from the better global economy. And even in the U.S., we're just coming off a 3% GDP quarter, and that's being reflected in the numbers. More specifically on what sectors are doing well, technology has been the big leader this year. It's up over 30%. You heard about the FANG stocks, like the Facebooks and the Apples and Netflix, but it's really more broad-based than that. And I think, again, at the end of the day, if the economy is doing better, more of that money, if the economy is doing better, these companies are selling more of their products, which is ultimately lifting earnings.
So you talked a little bit about the jolt to the stock market. Do you think we're due for a correction sometime soon?
Yeah, you know, it's the question that comes up quite a bit. And you know, we've now gone over a year without even a 3% pullback, which is very abnormal. In fact, that's the longest streak in history. The last time we've had even a 5% correction was last year after the Brexit. So it's a long time without a pullback, but I remember, you know, Peter Lynch, who was a famous Fidelity fund manager, said that there has been more money lost in anticipation of the correction as opposed to the correction itself. So in our view, you know, investors shouldn't be overly concerned about 5 and 10% corrections. That's the admission price to the stock market. What we focus and what we try to de-risk portfolios is when we think the risks are greater, meaning we're going into a recession. And right now, recession risk remains relatively low in our view.
Lerner says new